Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. This is one of the two cards that I am posting today as a guest designer for Alt & You. For this card I will be using this beautiful stamp set which is full of flowers. It is called Adore You. I am going to use the stamp set as well as the matching dies. So first I'm going to stamp a bunch of those flowers as well as some of the leaves. I am using an alcohol-friendly ink pad in black and I will color everything by using the Alt & You alcohol markers. I know that I want to create a flower arrangement at the top of my card, but at this stage I don't know how many flowers or how many leaves I'm going to use, so I'm just stamping a bunch to have enough for my flower composition later on. Now I'm going to bring in my Alt & You alcohol marker set. This is set A and that's the only set that has been released by Alt & You for now. They come with 12 different colors and you can see the three shades of green that I will be using for coloring my leaves. Now if you are a beginner with alcohol markers, I think that this is a great set for you because it gives you great colors to work with and I think they have a beautiful soft brass nib that is really juicy and you will see how beautiful they blend together. I'm going to put on some music and let you see how I colored a few of those leaves and then I will catch you back once I start coloring the flowers. And now we'll start coloring my flowers. I am going to show you the four shades of pink and reds that are included in the kit. I'm just going to use three of them. I won't use the darker one. And again, I'm using the same technique as I did for the leaves. So I'm starting with a lighter color, move on to the middle one and then to the darkest one. And if you notice, I color each petal separately, making sure that I add the darker color at the base of the petal. This is a great marker set for coloring flowers and not only you get shades of green and pinks and reds, you also get shades of blue so you can color your sky. Now I'm going to use this sparkly paper that has adhesive at the back and I'm going to cover up this rectangle panel completely. And you can also take a look on how beautiful those flowers and leaves look. I have used the matching dies to cut them out. And if you have a sparkly cardstock already in your stash, you can use that or you can even use embossing powder to add sparkle on any panel. So now I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the excess and I'm not going to throw it away, I'm just going to stick it back to that backing so I can use it another time. And now I'm going to use a die to cut out a frame out of this rectangle and this way I am creating a border where I can nest inside my flower arrangement. I have run it through my die cutting machine and I'm going to use only the frame but the inside I can keep it aside and use it for another card. And I made sure that my frame has the perfect size to cover up a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. Before I assemble my card I'm going to stamp the sentiment that says "You inspire me" and that's from the same stamp set as the rest of the flowers and the leaves. So I'm going to stamp that before I stick anything down since I am planning to use foam tape and everything is going to end up being too bulky and difficult to stamp. And since I am going for a window card, I want to have that frame slightly raised, so I am going to add some foam tape all around the border. And just because my foam tape is quite wide, I am going to cut it out in half just to make sure that it fits nicely around the frame. And now it's finally time for the fun part. I'm going to assemble my card, so I'm going to stick the frame on top of my card base. And after playing around a little bit with my images, I decided where the best placement was. So now I'm committing and I'm going to stick them down. For some of the images, I'm going to use foam squares to add a little bit of dimension. And for others, I'm going to use tape adhesive and stick them directly on my cardstock, so I have different layers. And when I am creating frames like that, I always like to have some of my cutouts coming out of the frame, just like I'm doing here with the leaves. I think these give a more interesting look to my design. I think this is a gorgeous card, and I really believe that the beauty of this design is that you can use it for pretty much any occasion. So all you have to do is to change the sentiment and you are good to go. Now, by changing the color of the flowers or changing the color of the frame, you get a totally different look, but perfect for any occasion. As a finishing touch, I used my glitter pen to add some shine on my flowers, and I am also going to use my white gel pen to add some dots at the center of the flowers as well. And that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. Don't forget to check out the other card that I made as a guest designer for Altenew today. Here are some close-up photos of the card. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and you can click on the video if you want to take a look on the other card that I created for Altenew as a guest designer today. Thank you all for watching!